द्रश्यं वरुणः शन्नो भवद्वर्यमा शन्न इन्द्रो बृहस्पतिः शन्नो विष्णुरुक्रमः नमो ब्रह्मणे नमस्ते वायो त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्म वदिष्यामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवतु तद्वक्तारमवतु अवतु माम् अवतु वक्तारम् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। टुडे वी चैंटेड भक्ति योग श्लोक संग्रह अलोंग विद दैट विभूति पादम द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ पतंजलि योग सूत्रास। देयर इज अ वेरी क्लोज रिलेशन बिटवीन दीज टू कंटेंट्स भक्ति योग एंड विभूति पाद। एज यू सी इन भगवद्गीता it is the conversation or communication between the Lord and the seeker, Krishna and Arjuna. Arjuna in the initial stages in great confusion whether to fight against Kauravas. As and when the chapters move on to the end, all his doubts get clarified. There are three sections in Bhagavad Gita, split into six and six and six chapters. First six chapters are dealing with karma, the action. The second six chapters, starting from seventh till 12th, is all bhakti, the devotion. Last six chapters are connected with knowledge. In Sanskritam it is called Jnanam. 13th chapter is Kshetra Kshetrajna Yoga, in which you find all the qualities of Jnani, and later on it is a kind of self-analysis, Trigunas and how a fellow who is caught with three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas, behaves. We are all under the clutches of sattva, rajas and tamas, because one of the shlokas say sattvam rajas tamah iti gunah prakriti sambhavah nibadhranti mahabhaho dehe dehinam avyayam. So this shloka says we are all under the clutches of trigunas, sattva, rajas and tamas. When we know something, when we are perceiving, meaning you are all sitting here, you know the condition is okay, it is not too hot, these are all perception. When you are perceiving, it does mean you are in sattva, meaning perception happens, the jnana happens only when you are in sattva. We are also in rajas because we are all active. Internally, our internal organs are active. There are voluntary and involuntary activities physiologically going on. This indicates we are also rajasic all the time. And tamasic, when we do not get anything, and it is apramada, apravritti or inert, these tendencies indicate that we are also tamasic. None of the human being is completely sattvic, rajasic or tamasic. We are all combination. Some time of the day is rajasic, tamasic and sattvic. This is how the categorization is done. This is the focus of last six chapters of Bhagavad Gita, which basically is knowledge base. So here we chanted today Vibhuti Yoga and Bhakti section of Patanjali Yoga Sutras. ततो अणिमादि प्रादुर्भावः काय संपत् अणिमा महिमा दीज आर ऑल डिफरेंट विभूतिस इफ यू स्टडी हठ योग प्रदीपिका एंड एनी अदर हठ योग टेक्स्ट यू विल कम अक्रॉस दी स्पेशल एबिलिटीज वॉट आर दी स्पेशल एबिलिटीज टू गिव एन एग्जाम्पल हनुमान जंप्ड फ्रम नो लास्ट सेक्शन ऑफ अवर कंट्री टू लंका okay it is one of the vibhutis generally we jump we have you know in athletics we have high jump we have long jumps and different types of jumps and javelins we have but without any instrument the fellow called Hanuman jumped from one another country this is one kind of vibhuti this special ability and meantime he came across with a demon called Sindhini his body was made huge very huge because he has to fly in the skies so the body of Hanuman was so huge that there was a condition unless any fellow who flies towards Lanka not as towards no aircrafts but at that time whoever was on that route should go into the mouth of that Sindhini and should come back and permitted to go further this was the condition and Hanuman assumed very small minute he became minute he was like a fly house fly so that is a vibhuti vibhuti meaning extraordinary ability This is what the third chapter of Patanjali Yoga Sutra is focusing on the vibhutis tataha anima adi pradurbhava kaya sampat kaya sampat tad dharma anabhidhatascha none of limitations will limit a person who has kaya sampat the special ability of the body no even some Puranic serials if you have seen a fellow comes with a big sword and cuts but the body doesn't get cut how this is how the kaya sampat is extraordinary or special ability of physical body how it is possible tataha with the previous sutra tada animadi pradurbhava kaya sampat kaya is this physical body sampat is the wealth one will have wealth of the body by doing sayama on different things these are the focus of third chapter you see one may disappear from wherever you are okay you are all sitting in the classroom but the class is so bored you want to get disappeared from the classroom okay it is possible Patanjali says it is possible okay it is no disappearance how disappearance happens because in modern science we all know how we perceive through eyes the sun rays or any light rays are being reflected on the surface that is being taken into the retina and it is processed in the brain then we perceive this is the process what if eye stop all the light being reflected towards the eyes of others then no one gets to know that I am sitting here this is the mechanism given in Patanjali Yoga Sutras how each and every siddhi or vibhuti is possible but it is difficult possible
is a only by using dharana dhana samadhi it is possible to have all these siddhis then as I said also the 11th and 12th chapters are dealing with the vibhuti of the Lord okay he says kiritinam gadinam chakranam cha tejo rashim sarvatah deeptimantam okay I see you as the thousand suns coming together and so bright it is full of light this is the vibhuti of the Lord okay he sees thousands of
hands, he sees thousands of eyes, he sees thousands of stomachs. Hey, Udaram, all the ornaments, everything is available. How? It is all the Vibhuti. If you analyze the word Vibhuti itself, the word has come from Bhu Dhatu. Bhu is Bhavati. Bhavati exists. Visheshena Bhavati. Vishesha means specially. It exists specially. So, Vivekananda just said, every soul is potentially divine. Means everyone has. But the purpose of education or any yoga practice is to bring out that speciality, that special ability. As you know, everyone, every individual in the universe is very unique. Though we are all human beings, each one of us having one or the other special and unique capabilities to perform, which is not possible anywhere by any other human being. This is what Bhagavad Gita beginning Arjuna says, Kushala Dharma. Kushala Dharma is special ability of any one of us. Thus, focusing on this Vibhuti, Pada of third chapter, and Bhakti Yoga, which says, which exhibits the Vibhuti or special capabilities of the Lord, we'll all meditate. Let's close our eyes. Let's keep our spine erect. Let us remember what unique quality that I have to nourish, to encourage, and to exhibit this session with prayer. One Omkara all together. Come to Namaskar Mudra. Inhale.